Welcome to the Eye of Truth. In my previous video about alien civilizations, I talked about seven types of civilizations that may exist throughout the universe. These are planetary civilizations, stellar civilizations, galactic civilizations, universal civilizations, multiversal civilizations, multidimensional civilizations, and creator civilizations. Our current civilization hasn't even become a Type 1 planetary civilization yet, and we're unfortunately stuck around level 0.72. These types of civilizations had been classified based on the theories of an astronomer named Nikolai Kardashev, and so there's no proof any of them exist. However, several recent discoveries may have suggested that a Type 2 stellar civilization may actually exist. As suggested by the name, a stellar civilization would have the technology to obtain most of its energy from stars. So, what kind of discoveries am I talking about? In this video, I'll be sharing some very interesting research findings. Be sure to stay with me until the end. In March 2009, NASA sent the Kepler Space Telescope into orbit around the Sun. The primary purpose of the telescope was to discover Earth-sized planets outside the solar system. Its field of view contains the constellations Cygnus, Lyra, and Draco within the Milky Way. All of the strange discoveries I'll be covering here were observed in Cygnus. Kepler uses what's called the transit method to search for planets outside the solar system. When a planet passes in front of a star, the two will overlap. When this occurs, the brightness of the star when observed by a telescope will decrease slightly. A planet would pass in front of a star regularly, so the change in brightness of the star could also be observed regularly. Once this regular change in brightness has been detected, we can estimate characteristics such as the size of the planet passing the star. Of course, when we use this method, these changes in brightness would occur at a regular interval, and the amount of change in brightness would be roughly the same each time. However, in September 2015, we saw something strange. There's a star called KIC-846-2852, located 1,400 light-years away from Earth in Cygnus. Let's call it KIC. Kepler detected changes in brightness from KIC, but the period at which it changed and the amount it changed both differed drastically from previous patterns observed in other stars. First, KIC's brightness didn't change regularly. As you can see in this graph, not only does the brightness change irregularly, but also it changes a different amount each time. Even if we extend the graph over a longer span of time, we can see that the changes are still irregular. NASA wasn't sure what to make of this. Technicians initially thought that Kepler was malfunctioning, but their investigation confirmed that the telescope was operating normally. Researchers decided to check older measurement data and discovered something astounding. On March 5, 2011, KIC's brightness suddenly dropped 15%. Then, in 2013, on February 28, and again on April 17, KIC's brightness dropped 22%. Similar occurrences were observed 10 times over a span of 6 years. This sudden drop in brightness is truly bizarre. Why? There's no way that this could be caused by planets. According to calculations, if an Earth-sized planet transited in front of KIC, it would cause a decrease in brightness of only around 0.01%. Jupiter is a truly massive planet, with a diameter 1/10 that of the Sun. Even so, Jupiter transiting in front of KIC would cause a decrease in brightness of only 1%. KIC has a radius 1.58 times that of the Sun. In order to cause a 22% decrease in brightness, the passing object would have to be at least as wide as half the radius of KIC. Could a planet of this size exist? No. Even if a planet of this size did exist, its core would have already begun undergoing nuclear fusion, and this planet would actually be a star. If a star passed in front of KIC, we wouldn't see a decrease in brightness. Could this decrease in brightness be caused by natural phenomena? No. A star does get gradually darker as it reaches the end of its life. However, a decrease of 22% would take several tens of thousands of years to occur. Therefore, the sudden and irregular darkening of KIC isn't due to natural phenomena and isn't due to planetary transiting. What about comets? Subsequent research has eliminated this as a cause. So, what could have caused this to happen? If we can't explain something using ordinary means, we need to look for our answer outside of the ordinary. The first possibility that comes to my mind is something called a Dyson sphere. I mentioned this previously in my videos on alien civilizations. A Dyson sphere is a concept that describes an advanced artificial structure, which was originated by a theoretical physicist named Freeman Dyson. He conjectured that, as a civilization became more advanced, it would ultimately become capable of obtaining energy from stars. One possible method such a civilization might use would be to cover the entire surface of a star with a massive structure to absorb energy released by the star. This structure is called a Dyson sphere. A Dyson sphere would of course require a considerable amount of labor, resources, and energy to construct. Although construction would start very slowly, the structure would at some point become capable of obtaining energy from its star, and the pace of construction would then begin to gradually accelerate. The speed at which the Dyson sphere is completed would gradually increase. Put another way, the star it covers would become increasingly darker. To some degree, this matches what we've observed with KIC. Of course, no one has confirmed the existence of a Dyson sphere around KIC, and this mysterious decrease in brightness doesn't prove the existence of a Type II civilization in Cygnus. However, I wouldn't have made this video if this was the only unsolved mystery from Cygnus. The fact that you're watching this video with this title means that something stranger must have happened. In 2021, a research paper was published in Nature. It mentioned that, on May 17, 2021, China's Large High Altitude Air Shower Observatory, LHAASO, had recorded gamma-ray photons measuring up to 1.4 PeV. These are the highest energy cosmic rays ever observed in human history, and researchers were shocked at the amount of energy. Let me try to express how powerful this is. Cosmic rays are a form of high-energy radiation that travel through outer space. They are composed of around 90% protons and 10% other particles. Cosmic rays travel through outer space at nearly the speed of light and are constantly bombarding Earth. The Earth is surrounded by an atmosphere. When cosmic rays hit the atmosphere, the particles they contain are destroyed. When what remains reaches the surface, much of the energy is already gone. This is why we can live on the surface without worrying about cosmic rays. A cosmic ray observation station is a system capable of detecting cosmic rays that reach the surface of the planet. Think of the cosmic rays detected by cosmic ray observation stations all over the world prior to May 17, 2021, as rain falling on the surface. Sometimes this rain is light, and sometimes it's heavy. However, no matter how strong these cosmic rays were, they were always just rain. The 1.4 PeV cosmic rays observed in 2021 are an order of magnitude stronger. How strong? Compared to a rain of cosmic rays, this was more like a concentrated water jet. A water jet can easily cut through metal. This radical difference between previous rains of cosmic rays and the 2021 water jet is what shocked researchers. You might have already guessed that this water jet came from Cygnus. Due to the effect of magnetic fields in outer space, the courses traveled by normal cosmic rays are constantly changing. This means that, when a cosmic ray observation station observes a normal cosmic ray, it cannot determine its origin. So, how do we know that the water jet came from Cygnus? We know because of the high number of photons contained inside them. Photons are not affected by magnetic fields. We could therefore determine where they came from, and the answer was Cygnus. Why did these special cosmic rays come from Cygnus? What created them? No one knows. Most researchers believe that this was caused by natural phenomena. But just think about it. It seems like too much of a coincidence. Cosmic rays unaffected by magnetic fields with an unbelievable amount of energy just happened to be sent straight to Earth, from Cygnus 1400 light years away. Many people are wondering whether such a coincidence is possible. Many have called for research into whether these cosmic rays might contain some kind of hidden message. Even so, it's unknown whether any of this kind of research is being conducted. Let's assume that these cosmic rays are not natural phenomena, but were instead created by an advanced civilization in Cygnus. What kind of science and technology might they have? The Large Hadron Collider, built by the European Organization for Nuclear Research, is capable of accelerating a single photon to 0.01 PeV. This is the best that we can currently do. Technology capable of accelerating a large number of photons to 1.4 PeV and then sending it 1,400 light-years away would need to be several thousands or even several tens of thousands of years more advanced than our current civilization. If these cosmic rays were indeed sent by an intelligent civilization in Cygnus, they would probably also have sufficient technology to create a Dyson sphere. But the mysterious constellation of Cygnus has yet another unsolved mystery for us. Cygnus contains a mesh-like nebula 77 light-years in width. Recently, a photo taken by a space telescope revealed a single straight line within this nebula. It seems too straight to be natural. An airplane flying in the sky will leave a similarly straight white line. The first time I saw this photo, I wondered whether it might be a trail left by a spacecraft. If so, this photo would suggest that the trail left by this craft is anywhere from 50 to 60 light-years long. If this trail soon disappeared like the vapor trail left by an airplane, the fact that such a long trail is shown in the photograph means that this craft had traveled a distance of 50 to 60 light-years in a very short period of time. If that's true, then the intelligent civilization in Cygnus could very well be at least a Type II stellar civilization. This is all just conjecture on my part. This straight line, the changes in KIC brightness, and the water jet cosmic rays are all probably just natural phenomena. However, all of these phenomena go beyond what we thought we knew. The fact that we're seeing so many strange things in Cygnus suggests that something we don't yet understand is out there. Even if it's not a Type II stellar civilization, it's certainly fascinating to consider what it might be.